We're back at Leading Edge. He is John Cranley. She is Teresa Fedor. They are a ticket on the Democratic side of the ledger in the race to become Ohio's next governor. He wants to be governor just this week. He asked her, and she said yes to being his lieutenant governor's candidate. Now, another challenge for both tickets in the Democratic sweepstakes face is the May primary. You team up against Dayton's Nan Whaley, former mayor this week, announcing a Clevelander, Cheryl Stevens, as her running mate. How do you overcome the apparent front runner? Is she the front runner? She was out first and picked up endorsements. We've got that. Without wounding her so deeply that she couldn't win the governor's race, should she be the party's nominee?
Well, first of all, I don't accept that she's the front runner, since that he's obviously a much bigger city than Dayton. I've run on the Democratic mantle far more times than she has. I respect her service, but I certainly don't accept that she's the front runner. Look, the bottom line is that at the end of the day, this isn't about partisan politics. It's about turning Ohio around in Ohio's comeback. Cincinnati's the only major city that's ever made a comeback from population decline to rising. These are just facts. But winning in a state that is tough to win for Democrats, this kind of record makes a difference. And we're the only team that has a comeback in place. And I believe if we're going to give people hope to win the general election, if we're going to convince some people that may have voted Republican in the past to vote for change, they need to vote for someone who's actually delivered change. And that's what we've done in Cincinnati. And candidly, neither Mike DeWine or my primary opponent have done that.
Senator Mayor Cranley wants to legalize recreational marijuana. You okay with that?
Legalize marijuana.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. The revenues will be then invested into 30,000 jobs that make at least $60,000 in a year. That's a game changer.
We have a school superintendent coming up on this program whose district is one of the many across the state of Ohio who filed suit this week against the state legislature's school voucher program or programs. What would the Cranley-Fedor ticket do with lawmakers, the current lawmakers' seeming love affair with everything threatening public education?
Trish, you want to start that one?
Sure. You know, I left the classroom to make a difference for public school teachers and our students, because if we don't invest into our public schools, it hurts all of our economy, especially our children and their future. And then we're going into the 25th year of an unconstitutional school funding formula. The first obligation for legislators is to follow the Constitution, and they haven't for 25 years. So they are creating a situation that's very harmful for Ohio, very harmful for our children, and they deserve a future. So I welcome that lawsuit and the course that it's going to take, because if we don't, and we privatize our public tax dollars, we will never see those pennies on the table. There's no transparency, accountability, and they have failed. We know they don't work.
According to the Trump FBI, they gave us the corrupt HB6 bribery scandal. Before that, they gave us ECOT. ECOT was a fictional school that Bill Lager gave millions and millions of dollars to Mike DeWine and to other Republicans, and kids were not educated. This is what happens when you let this one-party corrupt Republican Party in Columbus run public education. When Cranley Fedor get elected, we're going to put public education as a priority and stop these illegal schemes to siphon money from public schools to private or non-existent ECOT schools.
Does anybody else see the irony? The Speaker of the Ohio House is from Lima. The President of the Ohio Senate is from Lima. And the Lima School District is part of the lawsuit against the very funding that these guys have shepherded into reality. Let's wrap with this. Senator, no one has done more to salvage and restore the lives of people caught in the hideous web of human trafficking than you. Mayor Cranley, sir, founded the Innocence Project in Ohio, which has gotten innocent people, I say innocent as proven so by DNA evidence, out of prison. A person, Mr. Mayor, in your camp said your attraction to Senator Fedor joining you in the ticket was, and I'm just quoting them, her morality. It does seem that there's some type of a let's make a difference for the little people, the powerless, the voiceless out there that is part of this ticket's fabric.
Absolutely. We connected. We didn't know each other before this campaign started, but we immediately bonded over a commitment to social justice, to fighting for those who can't fight for themselves. I've grown the margins in Cincinnati, and Teresa spent her career fighting for those on the margins. you're right. The project I started has gotten 33 people out of prison, and she did the impossible, passed legislation with a supermajority of Republicans to stand up for survivors of human trafficking. These are two people that are in public service for the right reasons, and I promise you we can deliver a comeback for Ohio.
All right, John Cranley, Teresa Fedor, thank you on a busy, busy day and week this week for being with us. We'll talk again before the May primary. Best to you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And I'll be right back on Leading Edge.